Hey everyone, I'm Sam from Professional Music Technology, and over the next couple of videos, we're going to be taking a look at what we here at PMT consider to be some of the best synthesizers currently available. Now, throughout this two-part video series, we are going to be checking out quite a wide variety of keyboards, from vintage-inspired analog synthesizers, through powerful digital and hybrid models, right up to full-on workstations, which, as well as featuring great-sounding synth engines, also offer more traditional keyboard sounds and features, making them a really versatile all-in-one solution. So, depending on what you're looking for in a synth, hopefully we can recommend something that's going to suit your needs. So in no particular order, let's run through some of our favourite synths, keyboards and workstations for use in both the studio and for live performance. So for our first pick, since this video is all about synthesizers, we thought we'd take a step back in time to the golden age of analog synthesis and take a look at a model that harkens back to the classic early synths of the 1970s. It's the Moog Grandmother. Now, this is a fully analog, monophonic, semi-modular synthesizer inspired by the original classic Moog modular synths, meaning that as well as being able to create amazing sounds straight out of the box in its standard configuration, the supplied patch cables allow you to get really experimental with the signal paths between the modules, opening up a sonic playground with infinite possibilities for creativity. Those modules include two oscillators, each with a selectable waveform, envelope, filter and mixer sections with a white noise generator, a built-in authentic spring reverb tank, and an onboard arpeggiator and 256 step sequencer. And this is all housed in an awesome looking retro inspired design with 37 keys, pitch and modulation wheels, and also a portamento glide control knob. To ensure that this vintage inspired synth will integrate easily with your modern gear, there's standard MIDI and USB connectivity. And one of our favourite features is the audio input, which allows you to manipulate the sound of an external instrument or sound source, such as a bass guitar, for example, through the synth modules. So if you're after the authentic, all-analog sound and functionality of a vintage Moog modular synthesizer, but at a fraction of the price of what an original will cost you nowadays, this is definitely one of the best options out there. And if you do want to find out more, do go and check out our video on 5 reasons why you need a Moog Grandmother.
Thank you.
Next up, we're bringing things right up to date by taking a look at a very modern take on an analog synthesizer. It's the Korg Minilogue XD. Now, strictly speaking, you could probably call this a hybrid synth, as it combines Korg's amazing sounding analog synth engine from the original best-selling Monologue with a digital multi-sound generator and effects, all packaged in a very compact design with 37 mini keys and an intuitive control layout, making it easy to sculpt sounds without having to dive through lots of menus. The main synthesis parameters include two analog VCOs, each with saw, triangle and square wave options. A third sound generator comes in the form of the digital engine, offering either a noise generator, variable phase oscillator, or the option to load in your own custom oscillators. There's control knobs for attack, sustain, decay, and release. There's a mixer and filter section, and an LFO, again with selectable waveform. Add to this a high quality 32-bit digital effects processor packed with delay, reverb and modulation algorithms, and you've got the ability to create some truly huge sounds from this small synth. Being a polyphonic synth, there's four selectable voice modes, either four voice poly mode, unison mode where up to four voices can be layered to fatten sounds up, a single note chord mode and an arpeggiator latch mode. The digital elements also offer some very useful user interface options, such as the ability to save and recall up to 300 user programs. There's USB and MIDI connectivity, and a crisp, clear OLED display provides program change information, a handy oscilloscope, and completely pointlessly, but rather addictively, the ability to play a retro-style arcade game as the synth powers up. Along with all of this, there's also an onboard polyphonic step sequencer supporting both step and real-time recording, a joystick for control over parameters such as pitch and modulation, and the outputs are now stereo as opposed to the mono output found on the original Korg Monologue. So if you're after true analog synth tones but with digital versatility, the Korg Minilogue XD is a great option, and if space is limited in your studio, it's definitely one of the best small synthesizers out there. So sticking with Korg, the next model on our list of best synthesizers is the Wavestate, which tonally is a totally different beast from the Minilogue that we just looked at, as it utilizes wave sequencing synthesis. Now, this is a very unique sounding type of digital synthesis based around manipulating PCM waveforms, and it gained popularity back in the 1990s with the release of Korg's original Wavestation synth. The Wavestate, however, really is a next generation wave sequencing synthesizer, redesigned from the ground up to offer a much more hands-on approach when it comes to creating and tweaking sounds, and more versatile performance and connectivity options. Now, instead of going into too much detail here, I'm just going to leave a video linked up in the description where Luke Edwards from Korg gives us an in-depth demo of exactly what this amazing little synth is capable of. So if you do want to find out more about wave sequencing synthesis, definitely go and check that video out. But for now, if you're looking for something to add a bit more of a unique flavour to your production or live setup, get down to your nearest PMT store and have a play with the Korg Wavestate. It's capable of producing some really interesting, incredibly intricate sounds and loops, and it's great for creating those kind of gritty, glitchy tones or lush, ever-evolving soundscapes. We'll be right back. Now, as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, some of the keyboards on our list of best synthesizers are going to offer features outside of just pure synthesis and sound creation. And with that in mind, the next model we're looking at is the Roland Juno-DS, an ideal synthesizer for live performers, as it offers a huge selection of versatile preset sounds and features. It's really simple to use, with a large backlit screen that's easy to read on a dark stage, and it's very sturdy but lightweight, making it perfect for gigging. Today we're looking at the 61 note model, as it's the smallest and most portable version, but it is also available with either 76 or 88 keys, with the latter having a weighted key action more akin to a real piano. In terms of onboard sounds, there's over 1,000 authentic sounding instruments and drum kits to choose from, covering everything from pianos and organs through strings, brass, orchestral and percussion instruments, right up to electronic synth, pad and drum machine sounds. And the sound generator itself is capable of handling up to 128 voice polyphony and 16 parts, enough for even the most complex arrangements. So this means that the Juno isn't just limited to live performances, it's also a great synth for MIDI sequencing, either with a computer through the USB or MIDI interface, or with the onboard 8-track pattern sequencer, perfect for capturing songwriting ideas on the fly. To add depth and colour to your sounds, there's a high quality digital effects section, offering effects such as delays, reverbs and chorus. And four control knobs allow for the adjustment of various parameters, including synth light control over filter cutoff and resonance, and envelope controls for the attack and release of a sound. Instruments can be layered and split across the keyboard, which is pretty essential for live performances. And not only that, you can also import your own WAV files, which can be triggered and looped alongside the internal sounds by using the 8 phrase pads. In terms of connectivity, the rear panel features everything you'll need for playing live, such as stereo outputs and a sustain pedal input. And it's definitely worth mentioning that the Juno DS can also run on batteries, making it even more portable. Although do bear in mind that it doesn't actually feature built-in speakers, so you will still need either an amplifier or headphones to hear what you're playing. So if you're less about actual synthesis, you know, experimenting and creating your own sounds, and more about live performance or maybe songwriting, so you still need a wide range of sounds and functions at your fingertips, the Roland Juno DS is one of the best value all-rounder synth workstations and definitely worth checking out. Thank you. So if workstation and arranger style synthesizers are your kind of thing, the next model on our list kind of makes the Juno-DS look a little bit like a toy piano, which obviously it's not, as it's a great mid-level synth. But to put it into technical terms, this next one is the dog's box. It's Roland's flagship model, the Fantom. Now again, this is available in either 61, 76 or 88 note models. This one's got the 61 note semi-weighted keybed with aftertouch function. And although these do feature pretty comprehensive synthesis and sampling sections for the creation of sounds, the Fantoms are capable of so much more, designed to be your central hub for creativity and performance. Feature highlights include Roland's acclaimed V-piano technology, offering arguably the most realistic artificial piano sounds available, both in terms of actual sound and responsiveness. The Fantom's Zencore engine is a fully functional multi-part synthesizer, complete with oscillator, ADSR envelope, dual LFO, and a true analog filter. There's thousands of other high quality sounds courtesy of Roland's Supernatural engine, and these can be combined with either your own samples that can be imported or computer based soft synths. And with that in mind, easy main stage integration makes the Fantom the perfect master keyboard for live performers. There's also a powerful onboard 16 track sequencer, which records in either real time, perfect for capturing spontaneous creativity, or with a step sequencer taken from Roland's popular TR drum machines. Now obviously, I am only really just scratching the surface of what this incredible keyboard can do. So again, if you do want to find out more, make sure to go and watch our in-depth demo video featuring Roland artist Ashton Miranda, which I'll leave linked up below. So even though these are kind of at the top end of the price range on our list of best synths, if you are looking for an all-in-one synthesizer workstation solution that's going to be equally at home in both the studio and the live environment, you're not really going to find many better options than the Roland Fantom series. So for the final keyboard in part one of our best synthesizers rundown, we're going to kind of strip things a little more back to basics by taking a look at one of the best value all analog synths in terms of features, tone shaping options, and most importantly, the quality of the tones that it's capable of producing. And that's the Arturia Minibrute 2. Now, just like the Moog Grandmother that we kicked this video off with, the Minibrute 2 is a semi-modular, all-analog monophonic synth. And again, just like the Grandmother, its retro styling is reminiscent of those vintage modular synths that the Minibrute is obviously inspired by. The difference between this and something like the Moog, however, is that the Arturia comes in at under £500. So, as well as being a great addition to any studio, it's also a perfect option for anyone wanting to learn the ins and the outs of pure synthesis on a traditional analog synth. In terms of sound sculpting, tones are generated by two separate VCOs, allowing you to combine different waveforms within the oscillator mixer section, and you can also blend in an external sound source via the auxiliary input. There's a white noise generator, two independent LFOs, each with six different waveforms to choose from, both an ADSR and a separate AD envelope, a 12 dB Steiner-Parker filter module, which offers modes for low pass, band pass, high pass and notch filter, and the master amp section features Arturia's brute factor knob to add a little more of that classic analog grit and snarl to the tone. Obviously, being a semi-modular synth, the tonal path between these modules can be reconfigured by using the patch bay and the supplied patch cables, offering endless tonal possibilities if you want to get experimental. Or if that gets too confusing, you can still create really fat, warm analog synth tones by just ignoring the patch bay and using the Minibrute in its standard configuration. Aside from the synthesis modules, the Minibrute 2 also features a pretty powerful step sequencer, great for creating acid-y style bass lines. It features USB and MIDI connectivity, so it'll integrate easily into any setup, and it's available with either 25 full-size keys and pitch and modulation wheels like the one that we're looking at here today, or in a more step sequencer bass version without the keyboard. So it's not just one of the best affordable analog synths available, the Arturia Minibrute 2 will easily hold its own with some of the best analog synths out there. It's definitely one to check out. Thanks for watching. That was six of our favourite synths and keyboards that are currently available here at Professional Music Technology. As always, you can find out more about anything that you've seen here today at pmtonline.co.uk or get down to your nearest PMT store. If you enjoyed this video, please do give it a like and hit that subscribe button. And don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram as PMT House of Rock. And I'll be back with six more awesome synthesizers in part two. I'll see you soon.